So how many of you are scared of corona? I'm not. And it's not that I'm trying to pose that I'm very brave, but the fact is that it is more hyped than actual. And
in case any of us gets that infection, the chances are that we would be sick. But personally, me myself would not suffer so much. Yes, the sad part would be that I would have the potential to give it to others. So, corona is not so dangerous always for me myself who gets it, but for the people around us. So it is something that we need to prevent and learn about so that we do not become part of the chain. I am not scared. I said I am not scared. I am not scared because the numbers tell me that there is no need to be scared. So every time I say, WhatsApp tells us lots of good things. So there was one very good saying that every year in our country, we lose 16 lakh people to road accidents. And I still find young boys carrying the helmet in their hand even on a highway. So road accidents kill so much more and we are not so scared. We should really be scared of road accidents. We should really follow road rules, traffic rules. Corona is something that we all need to gear up to prevent the spread. So I need to be careful. I am very careful. Yes, I am very aware that I must know everything about corona. All my children should know everything about corona so that we help in case it knocks into our city or somewhere closer. We are the people who will not let it spread. We still do not know from where exactly this COVID-19 came. But today I was reading it that definitely it has not come from bats this time. Like there is a lot of rumors that it came through a bat and that lady who is eating a soup. So all that is fake. We still do not know where it comes from. All the viruses that would infect our body, get into our body through the respiratory system, through our lungs, the vocal cords or the nasal mucosa are into that respiratory group. The symptoms would be almost similar. It is a simple flu, it is a swine flu, it is a coronavirus or it is a SARS. The symptoms would almost be same. Now one thing that we all have to remember, because most of you right now are suffering from common cold, which is because of the change of weather. So one thing that would ease all of you who are having cold and cough is that coronavirus cough is not associated with any running nose. So most of you who have come to me for cough also have a running nose cold. So coronavirus, we have just dry hacking cough. There is no running nose, right? And this is about coronavirus, that it is large in size. So any simple mask, why should I tell you the size of this virus is that when it was swine flu epidemic, we were all hunting for that N95 mask because the virus is so small that normal surgical mask, the pore size is big enough to let it pass through. So if I have swine flu and I'm wearing a normal surgical mask and I cough or sneeze, the virus can come out of the mask. That is why we needed N95, those specific white thick masks. But coronavirus is very large in size, so any simple mask which acts like a barrier, so we just need a barrier. And we do not need it in a contained place like ours, because right now we know there is no coronavirus around us. Symptoms: fever, cough, myalgia is body pain, dyspnea is sans phoolna, fatigue is a lot of tiredness. So transmission. Now this is important. We must know how it goes from one person to the other. Coughing and sneezing without covering the mouth can disperse the droplets into the air. Cough, with the cough, the virus comes out, it is into the air. Now, it is large in size, as I told you, so it probably doesn't travel via the air unless the person is in very close proximity. Unless the person is sitting right next to me and I cough on the face and deposit the virus on the other person's nasal mucosa or the face or the lips, and then they touch it and you know it goes inside the mouth or nose, we cannot infect a person like that. So coughing and all, the virus comes into the air, but because it is very large in size, it normally settles on the ground or on the railings or other fomites. Why I am trying to stress on it, settles down on the fomites. Fomites means any object. It can be my table, my pencil, pen, the railing I was using, the seat I was sitting on. It comes and settles down there. So, touching or shaking hands with a person, the virus can pass. If I have corona, I have coughed, the virus is on my hand, I come and shake hands with you. So, I can transmit the virus to your hand, and from your hand you did this and it goes into your system. So it is not just corona, it can be a tuberculobacteria, it can be another virus or any other bacteria which is through the air, which is person to person transmission. So the best is to avoid unnecessarily touching the face, sitting this. You know, it's best not to touch surfaces and then our body. And also all young boys and girls that I have here, it will also, if you give away with this habit of touching your face unnecessarily, the chances of you getting acne, pimples, those pus-like pimples will also get lot reduced. Because pimples are also caused, the bad pimples, the small pimples, little whiteheads and all is normal. But the ugly pimples which leave a scar, which are pus-like, they are caused by bacterial infection, which normally comes due to our repeated touching of other surfaces and then our face. So who have more chances of getting infected? Very young children, older people and pregnant women. What can we do to prevent infection? Avoid close contact with people who are sick. Avoid touching our eyes, nose and mouth. Stay home when you are sick. Cover your cough and sneeze into a tissue and throw the tissue into a trash. Once we have made sure that whatever material has come out, we did not let it go into the air, it was in that tissue or in that handkerchief, which was safely deposited somewhere, the virus will die its own death. This virus can only live outside the human body with the potential power to infect other person for maximum of 12 minutes. And this maximum life is on a metal surface. On other surfaces, this life is less than 12 minutes. So it doesn't stay. So if we keep washing our hands, keep using alcohol to, you know, after we have been touched with surfaces in a public place. So when we are in our school, we are safe. We know there is no corona around us, and so there is no coronavirus on any of the objects. But say if we have gone to a mall, if we have gone to a public park, if we have come down a railing of an airport or a railway station, we must immediately disinfect our hands. So we are telling the public, keep a sanitizer in your car, so that when you go out, then you sit in the car, you sanitize. But hand washing is always and anytime superior to disinfection practices. Remember, the best method of keeping off all kinds of viruses and bacteria and all kinds of infection is perfect and right amount of and right technique of hand washing. And then if soap and water is not available, then use an alcohol based hand sanitizer with at least 60% alcohol. Otherwise, wash your hands. Wash your hands if you know you are going to touch your face. So before you wash your face, wash your hands and then wash your face. Right? Before you go to the dining hall, wash your face. You know, 2-3 ghante ho gaye hain. Wash your hands. So keep washing your hands, and that is the best practice for all kinds of problem. Worm infestation, bacterial infections, viral infections, coronaviral infections. For everything, hand washing cannot be stressed enough. So these are the hand washing 6 steps. Here we go. Soap. We have, yes, you all can do it with me. So we have done our palms. Then we do our spaces. Here we go with the fingers. Now the thumb. Now what is this for? The tips and the nail bed. Done. 20 seconds is not much of a time. Leave them to dry. It becomes bacteria and virus free. But no substitute to frequent right method of hand washing. Yes.
After that, if you are eating and then you go to the mouth, so it tastes.
Yes.
Bitter.
So I said.
It does not have any side effects.
No. It will only go into your mouth if you have used too much of it. See, sanitizer, and that's why we said at least 60% alcohol. What is the property of alcohol? It will evaporate. So sanitizer, which are not alcohol based and only have some fragments and all, we are not recommending. I do not know if they will actually harm, because they will have artificial flavors, artificial fragrances, and all these artificial flavors and fragrances are bad for health. That is why I am repeatedly saying I am not recommending, and I am definitely not recommending use of sanitizer before we eat. Definitely no. Where we go to eat, there is always a tap. First, matlab corona or no corona, for our own worms problem and our own stomach health, for diarrheas, for hepatitis, for liver problems, we should wash our hands thoroughly before we eat. So we have the slides back. There is no specific treatment. The onset of symptom and hospital admission is almost 7 days. Not all patients are hospitalized, and they can be sent home but kept in isolation, right? And there is no specific drug that is available. And like all respiratory infection, a very few such patients will land up with a pneumonia wherein the body cannot cope with the normal oxygen requirement and may have problems. Otherwise, it is like any other viral fever which will go off. This is some of the posters that Government of India has issued. Ye saral upay apnaye bukhar khansi saans lene mein takleef. Yadi aap 15 January ke baad Wuhan, China, kyunki us samay tak mere khayal se jab ye bana hoga tab Wuhan hi tha, ya kisi aisi jagah par gaye hain, to aap kisi health facility pe jaake you must get yourselves tested, right? So the virus spreads when cough droplets of a sick person get transferred to a healthy person. Eyes, nose, mouth. So these are warm places which are from where we gain entry. The air gains entry from these areas. Eyes also, remember, it's not just the nose and mouth. Eyes are also wet mucus, and this is from a sick person, it can go to a healthy person. So if you see someone who is coughing, sneezing, sick, you must maintain a 6 feet distance from the person, because these are large in size, cannot go very far. Avoid large gatherings, and I hope the school has cancelled your outings, because we do not wish our children to go out and get exposed to anyone who himself or herself may not be aware that they are harboring a coronaviral infection. Sometimes a sick person's saliva can get on other things like doorknobs, pens, mouse, tissue. That is why it is important that we dispose of the tissue and don't leave it on the table. Handrails and stairs. Handrails, most important, because the virus lives longest on metallic surface and on the face mask also. So whenever we remove the face mask, that also we need to be careful that it is disposed of scientifically. So accidentally touching these things and then touching your eyes, nose or face can make you get sick. How can we avoid getting infected? Wash your hands for at least 20 seconds after touching any container. You will not know ki kaun sa surface contaminated hai, kaun sa nahi hai. So we say any surface. When coughing, cover your face with a disposable tissue and mask and discard them immediately in a waste bin. Don't wear the mask for more than 1 day. In absence of disposables, you may sneeze into your folded elbow, because you have least chances of going and rubbing your elbow to someone else. Avoid handshakes. Greet with namaste. Avoid coming in contact with people who are sick. Avoid touching eyes, ears and nose. Use an alcohol-based sanitizer that contains at least 60% alcohol if soap and water is not available. Remember, sanitizers do not substitute for hand washing. Avoid sharing dishes, glasses, beddings and other household items with people who have flu-like symptoms. This is the same thing we are repeating. Clean and disinfect frequently touched objects and surfaces. And finally, seek medical advice if you are sick. I am always there.